Hi everyone, welcome back to the Axure RP repeater series. In this video, you'll learn how to dynamically sort the rows of a repeater's dataset in the web browser. This changes the order in which repetitions of the item appear. Sorting comes in especially handy when prototyping things like data tables and product listings. To get started, drag a repeater widget onto the canvas and go to its dataset in the style pane. Add two new rows to column 0 of the dataset, one with the value 4 and one with the value 5. Then, use the blue arrows above the dataset to scramble the rows so that the values are no longer in order. Next, drag a button widget onto the canvas and place it next to the repeater. Change the button's text to Add Sort. With the button selected, click New Interaction in the Interactions pane. Select the Click or Tap event in the list that appears, and then select the Add Sort action. Select the repeater widget in the Target dropdown. In the Name field, enter Toggle Column 0. You can name your sorts however you like, but we find that specifying the sort column and the sort order is most helpful. Leave Column 0 selected in the Column dropdown, and leave Number selected in the Sort As dropdown since the data in Column 0 is all numbers. The other Sort As options are Text, which sorts alphabetically and can be made case-sensitive, and two date formats, Year, Month, Day, and Month, Day, Year. In the Order dropdown, select Toggle, and leave Ascending selected in the default dropdown. This sort will target column 0 of the dataset, treat its data as numbers, and toggle the sort order back and forth between ascending and descending whenever the button is clicked. Click OK to save the action. Now let's add a button that removes the sorting from the repeater. Drag another button widget onto the canvas and change its text to Remove Sort. With the button widget selected, click New Interaction in the Interactions pane. Select the Click or Tap event in the list that appears, and then select the Remove Sort action. Select the repeater widget in the Target dropdown. Select the radio button for all and click OK to save the action. That second radio button is used to remove a specific sort by name. So, you could also remove the sort we just set up by selecting that option and entering Toggle Column 0 in the field next to it. This option is most helpful when you have multiple sorts applied to a repeater at the same time, such as sorting a list of products first by price and then by customer rating. Now we're ready to test everything out. Preview the page and click the Add Sort button to sort the repeater. Click the button again to change the rectangles to descending order. Finally, click the Remove Sort button to return the repeater to its unsorted state. That's all you need to get started with repeater sorting. In the next video, you'll learn how to dynamically filter the rows of a repeater's dataset in the web browser to display only rows that meet certain criteria. Thanks for watching, and happy prototyping.